TV23 KDGL. Covering the High Plains with news, weather, and information. From TV23 Studios in Sublette, this is High Plains Today.
Hi, everybody. You know what? It is Monday, July 18th, 2016. Welcome to The Real High Plains Today, right here on TV23. On today's show, Mike Brock. He is with Liberal Live on Stage. They got a bunch of shows coming up this year, and they're right now in their ticket drive. So we'll be talking to Mike about what they've got coming up. In the meantime, let's take a look at happenings. Well, strong storms blew through southwest Kansas Friday evening, pounding the area with heavy rain and high winds. Now, wind gusts up to 117 miles per hour were reported in Meade County. Winds overturned trucks on U.S. Highway 54, damaged mobile homes, downed power lines, and overturned a plane at the Meade Airport. Now, the National Weather Service precipitation map indicated rain of at least a half inch over much of the area, and some areas west and north of Garden City and in Ulysses area appearing to have received 2 or more inches. The National Weather Service reported a 74-mile-per-hour wind gust around 5:30 at the Garden City Regional Airport and 76-mile-an-hour wind gust in Gray County, roughly 10 miles west-southwest of Calvesta. And the Little River Healthcare has reached an agreement to provide administrative and management services for the Memorial Hospital of Texas County in Guymon. Now, the MHTC District Board of Directors announced the agreement at a publicly conducted board meeting on Monday, June 27th. The Memorial Hospital of Texas County Board of Directors sought a group to oversee the hospital's administrative duties, such as physician relations, marketing, general management, billing, and human resources. The board selected Little River because of its stellar track record of professional quality patient care, in addition to its history of reversing financial instability in Texas rural hospitals. As the state's most closely watched primary race enters its waning weeks between U.S. Representative Tim Huelskamp and Roger Marshall, national groups are dropping substantial sums of advertising dollars into this largely rural district. Now on Thursday, pollster Fritz Wenzel released the results of a two-day survey of Republicans in the 1st Congressional District, showing Marshall leads the incumbent by a 49-42 margin among the 615 people polled. 9% were unsure. Now, hours later, the Huelskamp campaign sent reporters the results of a poll it had commissioned. That survey by the polling company showed 47% of Republicans will vote for Huelskamp and 38% favor Marshall. 14% were undecided. Now, the August 2nd Republican primary poses the greatest threat to Huelskamp's 20-year career in politics as he seeks a fourth term in Congress after 4 terms in the Kansas Senate. Marshall, an obstetrician and hospital executive in Great Bend, has never held an elected office. And Kansas voters would choose Donald Trump over Hillary Clinton if the election were held today. But they are much more united in disapproval of Governor Sam Brownback. 47% of voters would pick Trump, the presumptive Republican nominee, while 36% would opt for presumptive Democratic nominee Clinton. Libertarian Gary Johnson would draw 8% of the vote, with 9% undecided. Now, a full 50% of Kansans hold an extremely unfavorable view of Brownback, while 22% have an unfavorable view. Only 17% view the second-term GOP governor favorably, while 5% view him extremely favorable. Now, these figures come from a Survey USA poll of Kansans commissioned by KSN-TV in Wichita. Pollsters conducted the survey last week. And advanced voting starts today in many counties. If you are a registered voter, remember, a valid, non-expired form of identification for in-person voting is required. Now, if you have any questions about where to vote and those types of things, be sure to contact your county clerk's office. And don't forget, we are giving away another 30-ounce Yeti tumbler this week. All you got to do is email us at cup@kdgltv.com, or you can send us a postcard, too, if you want. TV23, KDGL, P.O. Box 447, Sublette America 67877. Don't forget, Email us, send us a card, whatever. But you want to register one of these. I put ice in this like last week. It still has some ice in it. No, not really, but they are really good, and they stay cold all day long. That's a look at what's happening out there. Going to be back with a warm, and more warm forecast after this.
You're watching High Plains Today on TV 23 with host Chris Jewell. TV23's internet service and 4G live streaming provided by United Wireless. Coverage you deserve. Service you expect. United Wireless.
Did you know kids who play outdoors have healthier lungs?
Totally.
Did you know that boys that play with dolls make better husbands?
My son has lots of dolls. But did you know terrycloth diapers breathe better?
I did.
Mm-hmm. It's totally true.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Did you guys know statistically friendly kids have more friends?
Yeah.
That's obvious.
Did you know most people think they're using the right car seat for their kid, but they're not?
Parents who really know it all know for sure that their child is in the right seat. Visit safercar.gov/the right seat to make sure your child is protected.
Now, the local weather forecast for the High Plains.
And welcome back. Hey, we're looking off to the northwest on the TV 23 tower cam. You can see lots of sunshine. No clouds. Going to be warm today. Looking at our current temperatures and readings here at the station, it's already 86 degrees. Relative humidity, a little sticky out there, 58%. Winds are only out of the southeast at 4 miles an hour. Barometric pressure holding steady. Taking a look at the current temps around the region, everybody already into the 80s. Look at you get down to the southern side of the viewing area. Perryton and Guymon already at 93. It's going to do nothing but get warmer, folks. I'm just saying. Looking at our dew points around the area, everybody in the 60s, except you get down into the panhandles, they're just down in the 50s. So relative humidity is in the 50-60% area. Not a lot of wind, as you can see out there. Liberal at 14 at south-southwest. Perryton, 23. Everybody else, you get up here to the north. Look at Garden City, only 6 and variable. Taking a look at our highs and lows as recorded at the Garden City Regional Airport. We did get to 96 yesterday, 107 back in 1978. Low yesterday morning, 69 degrees, 56 back in 2014. Ooh, how pleasant was that? And look, on Friday and Saturday, we had almost 3 inches of precipitation over the weekend through those storms on Friday and Saturday that rolled through the area. All right, here we go. Looking at our forecast for today, 99. Southern parts of the area, I wouldn't be surprised if we saw 100. Winds are only going to be out of the south at 18, so it's not going to be real cool feeling out there. Tonight, mostly clear. Low's only going to be 69. Winds are going to be out of the south at 18. Could gust up to 28 miles an hour. Then they'll lay down a little bit after midnight. Tomorrow, 97. Sunny, sunny, sunny. Winds out of the south at 14, gusting up to 20. Tomorrow night, yeah, it's not going to warm up, cool down very much either. 71 degrees for our low, clear skies. South winds out of the south at 18. Then you, okay, It's just going to get hotter, all right? We cool down on Sunday to 94. That's going to be the coolest day. Do have a chance of some showers rolling in over the weekend. But look at that, on Wednesday and Thursday and Friday, triple digits. That's a look at the weather. Be back with the markets and Mike after this.
So, same time next week?
Well, of course. Put away a few bucks, feel like a million bucks. For free tips to help you save, go to Feed the Pig.
When you throw away money on wasted electricity, you're throwing away everything you could have bought with it. Saving energy saves you money. Learn more at energysavers.gov.
Chris Jewell, host of High Plains Today, a 30-minute news and information program that airs at noon weekdays right here on TV 23. Hey, do you think you have an idea for something that would make a great segment? Somebody that would make a great interview? What about a community event that needs highlighting? Let us know here at the station. Email us, news@kdgltv.com.
When some people struggle with their mortgage payments, they become frozen, petrified, not knowing what to do. They do nothing. But the people who do something, the people who take action, are far more likely to get the most positive outcome. Making Home Affordable is a free government program. Call now to talk one-on-one with a housing expert about the options that are right for you. Real help, real answers, right now.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back. I'm now joined in studio by Mr. Mike Brock. He is the president of Liberal Live on Stage. And they've got their big, I don't know, do I call it a membership drive?
Yes.
Okay. All right, you're selling tickets.
We are selling memberships.
Let me get it right. Okay. Now, how long? Okay, Liberal's been doing Live on Stage for a lot of years.
The community concert
type
events have been going on in Liberal for a very long time, since about the 40s.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know it went back that far.
It is.
I know they've been doing it for a lot of years. Yeah, it was community concerts, and it became Live on Stage. And
so, it's been Live on Stage probably about 20 years now.
Really? Has it been that long? It just seems like yesterday, doesn't it?
It does.
No, it doesn't. How long have you been involved with Live on Stage?
Live on Stage, I got involved back in 2004.
So you've been doing it a while.
For a while, yeah.
Yeah.
But I remember it as a kid. My parents took us to concerts, and through my education with the college and the high school music departments, it was always stressed that we needed to attend the concerts, and got to see a lot of different entertainment.
They do have a lot of good acts. All right, and you have four concerts coming up, right, in the 2016-17 season.
Uh-huh.
And the first one is in, what,
October
13th, yeah. And it's going to be the Blackwood Brothers.
A lot of variety in this lineup, starting off with good old Southern Gospel.
Okay, because now the Blackwood Brothers, now this isn't going to be the same Blackwood Brother. I mean, because the Blackwood Brothers name has been around for a long time, hasn't it?
But I think there's still a family connection.
Is there? So if you want to hear some good old gospel quartet singing a la, well, they were kind of an influence on the Statler Brothers and those types of acts,
Statler
too,
Brothers and
back in the day, weren't they, the Blackwood Brothers?
Most definitely.
Yeah, so that'll be fun if you want to hear stuff like that. Yeah. Okay, and then next coming up, you have your Christmas show. We're talking about Christmas, and it's going to be 99 degrees today.
Yeah, Christmas in July.
That'll cool you down.
It will. Thoughts of snow and the hustle and bustle.
Yeah, there you go. All right, it's going to be Tenore.
Tenore, a group of tenors that will do a variety of music, focusing on Christmas. So it's something that their normal show that they travel around the country with.
Tenore, okay, so Tenore, Italian?
Italian.
Or tenor?
Or tenor.
Huh?
And they'll do a few foreign language songs, but mostly it will be the Christmas feel good, get you in the mood type concert.
All right. And then after that, you have, now tell me about Victoria Banks. We're talking a little bit about her before we came back, and she's going to be in January, but she is a young Canadian artist.
She is a Canadian artist that performs country music.
Okay.
A little bit of variety, not solely country, but that seems to be the main focus. Plays the guitar, has a backup piano player that performs with her, and really, you know, good looking, very very strong musician. So,
all right, and then you round out with the All American Boys Chorus.
That's correct.
Okay, tell me about the All-American Boys Chorus. What do you know about them?
Well, they're a group based out of New York City, and they're young, but they don't sound as young as they look. They have incredible voices.
How many of them are there in the chorus?
40.
40? Yeah. Wow.
Can you imagine traveling with 40...
Adolescents? No,
in a bus?
No. No, not at all. I would not sign up for that job.
Definitely not.
Would you?
Well, I've done my share through Boy Scouts, so I know what bus life is with 40 to 50 kids. So.
All right. Yeah, but traveling around the country, though,
They're not the typical group.
Well, that's true.
They were probably the biggest challenge to us as far as setting the schedule, because they only allow the kids to be on the road for certain amounts of time. So,
oh, okay. Well, that makes sense.
They may travel for 4 days, but they're in four or five different locations during that period of time.
So. All right, and then it's back home and get to school.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, now tell me a little bit about, now, because live on stage, they have a whole catalog of people that you can, I mean, it's like a catalog. You can choose from acts, right? Different kinds of acts. I mean, you have everything. I mean, you name it, they have it.
Coming up in Nashville, they bring their catalog to the performing center there, and every group that they advertise in their catalog, with the exception of some that are in Europe that can't make the trip, but they get a chance to perform live for the live on stage representatives from across the country. We go there, we can see it in person, or they videotape that, and we watch it and try and figure out what's going to be a good mix and be well received in our community here.
So how do you decide that? I mean, you look back on, okay, what people liked before, or do we want to kind of go out on the edge here and push the edge and see, let's try this. Okay, maybe not. Well, we tried this once. Not going to do that again.
Everything that you just mentioned is, we have about 25 people that get into a room that review that. We have a booking agent out of Nashville this year that kind of can take a look at what we've booked in the past and look at the new acts and say, these are the things you should look at. But ultimately, the group here in Liberal, we choose the concerts that...
You have 25 of you that arm wrestle in this deal?
Yeah.
It's kind of like America's Got Talent, and you go back and make the judges' cuts, right?
It is tough. And that gamble of what the crowd will like. A few years ago, 10 years ago, you didn't see any country on the lineup for live on stage. It was more of a classical-based group of concerts.
Big bands, you had a lot of big bands.
Big bands, pianists, string quartets, the Dallas Brass.
Yes.
And those groups are still around.
And those guys are still good. Yeah, and they're still good.
They've added a little variety to their acts, so they're not just playing classical, so it's a very entertaining concert. But we go back and we say, the crowds really liked, and it's amazing when we look at these groups, And we pick something that is a little out there, that's taking a chance and not too sure about it. And sure enough, those are the concerts that people just walk out of the auditorium saying, one of the best concerts we've ever seen.
That's the best thing I've seen in 100 years, right? Yeah. I'll tell you, the one that surprised me was you had Floyd Kramer, the piano player's grandson.
Jason Coleman.
I thought, this isn't going to be. He was good.
First time we had him.
He played those slip notes, and wow, he was good.
I had seen his grandfather originally at a live on stage concert there in Liberal back in the 80s.
Oh, really?
And I knew what I was expecting. And
he delivered, didn't he?
And he did deliver. I wasn't expecting his grandson to be as good.
But he was.
And he put on a long concert without an intermission, and it just flew by. So.
All right. Well, Brian's yelling at me. We got to go. But right now, let's talk about your memberships. They can get a hold of you at 482-0466. And a single membership for an adult is $60. Family, $135. And students, $20. Best deal you'll have. Can't see better entertainment for that money.
Right here.
Thanks, Mike.
You're welcome.
We'll talk to you again when it gets closer. Stick around. I'll be back with more after this.
As the owner of a business, I'm responsible for all these kids. No, I can't make sure they get all the fruits and veggies they need, or that they have good table manners, or that they use their inside voices, but I can make sure they get the support they need by reporting all my new hires to the state of Kansas.
When you report new hires, you make sure non-custodial parents pay their child support so kids get what they need to succeed in life.
Join me in doing one simple thing to help kids.
So, same time next week?
Well, of course. Put away a few bucks, feel like $1 million. For free tips to help you save, go to Feed the Pig.
Matt, let's take a look at some sports. Hey, they walked off the 18th green together, arm in arm, and forever linked by one of golf's greatest duels, Henrik Stenson and Phil Mickelson. Stenson claimed the Claret Jug, a major champion for the first time at the age of 40. All it took was 10 birdies and a magnificent 8-under 63 in the final round of the British Open. Now, right on his heels, almost to the very end, was Phil Mickelson. He shot a bogey-free 65, good enough to win just about any other tournament, but Henriksen was better than he was yesterday. It was quite a deal. And the Royals, they're still slumping. They are now at 46 and 45 for the season. They gave up a walk-off yesterday in Detroit, lost that series, and now they got an important one coming up. They start with Cleveland, three-game series tonight at the K in Kansas City. Let's take a look at the weather before we get out of here. Hey, it's up 2 degrees, 88. Right now, relative humidity 54%. Winds are out of the southeast at 6. Barometric pressure is still holding steady. Taking a look, yep, they're going to be 99 today, 97 tomorrow, 100 Wednesday, 101, 101. 98 cooling down to 94 on Sunday. Go out and make it a good Monday, everybody. See you tomorrow.
Keep up to date with the latest information from TV23 on our Facebook page, KDGL-TV.
Hi, Chris Jewell, host of High Plains Today, a 30-minute news and information program that airs weekdays at noon right here on TV23. We talk about news, we talk about sports, we talk about weather, we're even going to talk entertainment. We'll have live guests right here on set with me. So, every day at noon, tune in, High Plains Today. We'll see you then.
Weekdays here on TV23.
Traditional light bulbs actually generate 9 times more heat than light. Switch to Energy Star light bulbs. and you'll realize just how much cash you are really burning through. Saving energy saves you money. Learn more at